Beetlejuice.
It's showtime.
What's up, everybody? Thanks for listening to Sinister Scripts Podcast. I am your host, Ryan.
And I'm your other host, David.
And we're going to be taking you through the cinema of one Cherokee Creek this afternoon. We'll call it a raunchy horror comedy, I guess.
With a Sasquatch.
So this one was interesting. We were actually at a convention down in Atlanta this past January, Days of the Dead. If you haven't been to that, definitely go check it out. A lot of cool
check it out.
Celebrities and vendors. And we ran across a booth for a producer who produced this film. And he had a bunch of movies out on the desk. And we kind of did a grab bag. And this was the first one that we picked. Highly recommended.
It was what he basically say, if you guys want to see a movie with Sasquatch ripping dicks, this is your cut.
I mean,
something along those lines.
Yeah, that's all I needed. That's all I needed to hear. I was like, I'm sold. Let's check it out. So the movie opens with two hillbillies out for a leisurely stroll in their rowboat or whatever, and on a Sasquatch hunt. So they're out in the woods looking for Sasquatch, which seems like a dumb idea.
Yeah, just kind of stupid. Yeah, like whatever.
But you find out a couple rules really quickly about this Sasquatch. Number one, he's very territorial. So there will be no urinating in the woods.
No urinating, no jizzing, was it?
Correct. And the final one was no having sex. So pretty standard like horror trope there. But as far as like the no urinating and jizzing, I guess it's...
that was very odd.
Yeah, maybe he's...
and I guess very specific.
He smells the bodily excretions.
Smells the man juice.
So we've got, that's kind of where we open with. And then, so very quickly we find out that, Cletus, who's the smart one. Yes. His name really is Cletus.
It was.
He hands a bottle for his buddy because his buddy's got to take a leak. So his buddy proceeds to go behind the trees and of course piss all over himself.
Yeah, I was going to say, didn't he like spill it all over himself?
Yeah. Like who's ever been on a road trip before? Like you've had to pee in a can or a bottle as a guy, like it happens. But this guy apparently never done that. Pisses all over the place.
Yeah, no clue.
Which, of course, you guessed it, attracts the Sasquatch. So he shows up and makes quick work of Cletus and his...
Oh, the other guy, I can't remember his
name. His piss-covered friend. We'll just call it at that.
Pee-pee pants.
So that's kind of how the movie starts and kind of our first introduction to the lore of Cherokee Creek and the Sasquatch. Yeah. So that's really... I mean, what are your thoughts on that? I mean, the kind of the cold open. I mean, I thought it was... promising.
Yeah, it was definitely promising. It was like, okay, the Sasquatch is here to fucking kill and maim some people. And obviously when they went over the rules, number one, I was like, somebody is jizzing somewhere in the woods at some point.
100%.
Otherwise, why would they bring it up?
Exactly. That's foreshadowing for sure. I also like the whole thing when Cletus hands in the bottle to take a leak. He's like, oh, the rule is if you spill it, you got to drink it. And
oh,
I was like,
yeah.
I was like, who the fuck made these rules up? Like, first of all, I'm not drinking piss.
Yeah,
second of all, like I kind of wish that Sasquatch would have let him live until he had to drink the piss because he clearly pissed all over himself.
He had pissed all over himself. Yeah.
So that was an interesting rule. But overall, I was like, okay, good start here. We've got, you know, kind of that whole like, and it kind of had a very 80s creature flick feel to it. So
it
I was
did,
like, all right, good start. Like, you know, a couple idiots go out in the woods, creature kills them, and we're moving on. So I was like, all right, so far so good.
Yeah.
So we move on to what we're going to call, I guess, the intro scene one, which we get a view of a driver in a van watching porn on his cell phone. And this is a child molester van. It looks like it should have free ice cream.
No windows.
Yeah. It looks like it has carpeted ceiling on the inside. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it turns out that they are kidnappers. So they're talking about... you know, normal things in a raunchy horror comedy. They're talking about getting dick sucked, and one guy brags about one woman being a legendary squirter.
I mean, because
these guys are class acts.
They're classy guys. They're my kind of dudes.
So they break into the house
with a gun. The dude's shitting on the toilet.
Correct.
When they run in there.
Correct.
And would they try to chloroform him or something?
But
he passes out, so they have to like pull his pants back up, drag him out of the house.
Yep, throw him in the van. They tie him up and throw him in the van. Which at that point he's passed out. I don't know why you had to tie him up.
Yeah.
Anyway, they did that. They throw him in the van, and midway to their destination, the kidnappy grabs the gun and shoots a hole in the roof.
Yeah.
So he wakes up, shoots a hole in the roof. They subdue him by putting the used cum rag from the guy in the front seat over his mouth.
The cum rag on his face.
Exactly. So they get their destination and they put the guy on his knees and it looks like they're about to execute him. Mm-hmm. And then surprise twist.
We're your boys. We're having a bachelor party in the middle of the woods.
Exactly. So, yes, this was all a hoax, which that brings me to my point number two. Why was the gun loaded?
Right?
This was like, your friend.
Yeah, somebody could have died.
Right. This is
somebody
your friend.
Should have died.
You put a cum rag in his mouth. You almost shoot him, and you kidnap him while he's taking a dump.
Yeah, like what a bunch of shitty-ass friends.
Right. So far, he should probably just get new friends.
Yeah.
So that's kind of where we're at now. So we'll stop there. We've kind of been commenting on some of the things along the way. But yeah, so now they're around the fire, and they're going to do a camp, whatever, I guess camping for the weekend with their boys.
Yeah.
So.
And I remember the guy was freaking out about his girlfriend, like, oh, she can't know we're up here. There can't be any booze or any, like, anything fun.
Booze or boobs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's like, we can't do it. She's going to find out.
So, of course, he's got, like, the uptight fiance.
The uppity ass bitch.
Exactly. So that's kind of, I mean, I feel like we're really following on this, all these horror tropes where we've got, you know, the fake kidnapping, and now we're in the woods. And so this kind of makes me, kind of made me think of a little Friday the 13th kind of thing.
Little bit, yeah.
Right. So obviously it's a creature versus a slasher, and, you know, so to speak. But so we are telling ghost stories around, and there's this, what's the guy's name? Chad. He's the raging atheist dick, and everyone hates him.
Yeah.
They don't know why he's there. They're like, who invited this guy? But apparently one of the main characters brought him on and said he's
invited him on the down low. And and I remember they kept bringing up the fact that he was atheist, but like not to a point that made sense.
It was just like it was just a fact that never had any reason to be.
Yeah, it had no rhyme or reason to be there, but
right.
He was a D-bag for sure.
Right. So this guy, Chad's there. He's pissing everybody off. And then the park ranger shows up.
Oh, God, the park ranger.
She is not amused that they are in a no trespassing area. And Uncle, as they call him, is trying to sweet talk his way out of it. And it turns out that the ranger is a huge fan of one of the characters, Mr. Vinny Blades. Apparently, he was in some, I think it was like a film
action star.
Star?
Yeah, he was like an action star, apparently. Yeah.
But Vinny is pretty much exactly what you expect. Just the long-haired, greasy, like, womanizer.
Yeah.
Just looks like he, you know, lives in a trailer park.
Yeah, he looks pretty skeezy, but apparently all the ladies love him.
Right.
And the park ranger is like, oh, my God, what was this? Like, sign my chest. Like, doesn't he sign her chest?
Yep. He agrees. She agrees to let him stay overnight if he'll sign an autograph. And, of course, it ends up being the chest autograph. And then Vinny, being the scumbag that he is, gives the cop a special brownie that he breaks up for the bachelor party.
And then they all start partying, yeah.
Exactly. And which is kind of funny. Like, this park ranger, law enforcement, shows up and is like, sure, let me have a brownie from this random stranger who looks like he cooks meth in the basement of
but he's an action star and I want him.
Exactly. So she digs right in, and, you know, we can see where that, you know, gets us. So he signs her tits and we're moving on here. So that's kind of the first, like, I guess we'll call it act of the movie, right?
Yeah.
They're kind of out there. They're in the
woods.
Setting
the mood.
Having fun. They're partying. They're drinking. And they're hating on Chad, the atheist.
Yeah.
And then they see some lights in the distance and they all get a little bit freaked out, right? And it was, who was it? Was the uncle was like, it's aliens.
Yeah. Well, didn't Chad get knocked out or something before?
Yeah, I think Uncle knocked him out.
Yeah.
So he's knocked out and they put him in the tent.
And they put him in the tent, that's right.
Exactly. So when they see the lights, what is it? Vinny said he's going to, quote, switchblade their asses.
Classic Vinny Blades.
You know, Uncle says it's aliens, and it turns out to be not aliens.
But strippers.
All right, so we're into, like, our third, like, horror movie trope of the movie, which is strippers. So they show up, and of course, they're what you'd expect in a...
Yeah, wearing nothing really, in high heels in the middle of the woods.
Right, yeah, exactly. Giant high heels. And so they're, you know, they're like, let's get this party started. Terrible dancing. The music was awesome, I remember.
Yeah.
It was like very, like, just
generic
techno. But then I know that the character Brick goes to take a piss, which is, as we know from the very beginning, this is a big no-no, right? So in the meantime, while this is going on, there is a bouncer or bodyguard.
I think he was the pimp of the girls. He was their handler,
he was the muscle.
The muscle, yeah.
And so in the meantime, it shows him, and he gets taken out by
the Sasquatch.
The Sasquatch.
But, like, was Brick, was he the one that we were like, oh, he's definitely jerking off in the woods and getting killed.
Yeah.
Because he was jerking in the van. Yeah.
Exactly. Yep. So, yeah. So he, Bigfoot gets the handler, pimp, bodyguard, whatever.
Yeah.
And then it kind of cuts to the bride, who is the one who's uptight, remember, about being at a the strippers and the booze. She's at a male strip show.
So, oh, that's right. Yeah.
Hypocrite much.
And she's partying her ass off there the whole time and just typical. Yeah. She's just like, oh, he better not be doing this while she's got like a freaking mouthful of cock and whatever.
Exactly. So Chad, the guy who's the atheist Chad who got knocked out, comes to sees the strippers and decides, I'm going to film this on video and send it to the bride to be. So total dick move. How are you going to turn your boy in like that? So she storms out. Okay. She gets, and then the getaway gets even crazier. They even bring out the whipped cream bikini. So I feel like they're following every
that's where, cause you said they wanted to kind of do it like American Pie.
Yep.
Style.
Yep.
There you go.
I was listening to a podcast talking about this and they were saying that he wanted it to be like American Pie mixed with Friday the 13th mixed with a creature flick. So we've got that going on, and the dumb bride leaves a crazy message about how dare you, like, I know there's strippers, I know there's booze. Poor Pat. He should probably, first of all, he's got shit friends, and he's got a shit fiance.
And he's got a shit fiance. Yeah, that guy's not winning at life at all.
Right. So the bouncer comes out and says,
The hero of the movie.
The hero of the movie. This is the best line in the movie. The bouncer at the male strip club comes out, and he says, no one's marrying a dumb bitch who is at a dick bar every weekend. Just go home and feed your cats. Classic. Like
I was like falling out of the chair laughing that whole speech this guy had for this chick.
Like this guy's whole career sums up to this one line, and it's an epic line in a raunchy horror comedy indie film.
They could have taken like 20 minutes of other screen time throughout this movie and just given it strictly to that dude for just like bashing on this chick. It was great.
Exactly. So now we kind of go back to the bachelor party, and this is where it kind of starts to get a little bit more Sasquatch involved.
Yeah, him looking around the woods and that kind of stuff.
Exactly. What's the fat guy's name again?
Was it Drew?
Drew.
Fat guy.
We just called him Fat Guy, but I think it was Drew. So he is a aspiring actor, dipshit extraordinaire. He dresses up like Bigfoot to scare everyone. So the legend is that Bigfoot's out here. Yeah. So he decides it's going to be funny to dress up in a Bigfoot costume and scare everyone. So the strippers are actually taking a piss, which why do we see? We don't need a scene. There's a lot of like pissing scenes in this movie.
Way too many.
I mean, I understand that you like they kind of set it up with like the whole like don't pee in the woods, but like,
yeah,
I don't need like a 7 minute long scene of like strippers peeing.
Yeah, but was it the fat guy in the suit, or I thought they hired another actor?
He did, but then I thought he ended up in the suit. Either way, he did hire the actor that came late. I remember he was late.
We'll get to his part later.
Yeah, there's more to come for there. So, and they're talking. So these strippers are taking a leak, and they're talking about double teaming Vinny Blades because he is such a stud and a big rock star.
Such a stud.
So once again, this is Vinny Blades is, you know, he's the guy in this one. He is the man. Exactly. So they see a bloody handprint, and that the actor that was in the Bigfoot costume put there, and they start freaking out. And Chad's all mad because they left him to go, and so he pisses in their cooler. Remember, he opens up the cooler full of beer.
And he pisses in the tents, too, right?
Right, like fucking Chad. This guy is the worst. Nobody wants him there. He's an atheist, which I guess doesn't matter, whatever.
Yeah.
But then everybody hates him, and now he gets knocked out. Then he sends the video to the bride.
Oh, that's right.
And then
right.
he pisses in the cooler.
And then he pissed, what a douche.
Chad just showed. So he gets mad, pisses in the cooler. And all the tents, including his tent.
His tent, yeah. Like, what an ass clown.
Yeah. So Sasquatch is throwing rocks now at Chad. So now he's scared and in the tent, and Sasquatch is a little bit toying with him. I think it's a little bit of karma. He deserves this.
Yeah, he deserves everything.
So, and at this point, we kind of go to Fat Guy, right? Fat Guy, Drew, walking through the woods, and he's got the bubble guts.
Oh, that's right. a fucking, and he was, yeah, he was like farting as he was running along.
He's got the bubble guts and he's about to shit himself in the woods, which if you've ever shit in the woods, it's not a pleasant thing to do anyway.
I can't imagine it
so
would be.
So if you have the bad guts, I'm guessing it's probably worse. So he stops to take what is a very graphic on-screen shit.
Yes, it was just like, come on, pissing and now this.
So we're continuing down this whole, like, you can see the horror in it, but you can also see like just this raunchy, like, American Pie, like, just like
toilet humor.
Exactly. Kinda. I don't hate it.
No, it's just, yeah, it was just not expected. Like, oh, okay, he is shitting. I know this for a fact.
Exactly. Ends up wiping with his sock, which is where he explains how bad it smells. So we get a lot of detail on this. And Sasquatch is not amused by this. He's watching the whole time and slaughters him pretty graphically.
Yeah, I remember that.
So Sasquatch has finally made his first like big kill.
Official kill.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like one of the main characters.
Characters.
So that kind of leads to part two. Mm-hmm. You know, and part three is just when it's just complete mayhem.
Yeah.
So Bigfoot is literally like crushing dudes and ladies left and right. I mean, he ends up killing one of the strippers. He rips off her tits.
Oh, yeah. He claws it off or whatever.
Like her entire chest.
And like they were pretty graphic with the sex scenes that they were doing in there too. Like before that, like I was a little, I was just kind of like, this is weird where they like basically flipping a coin, like not Vinny Blades, but the other guy who looked just like him, like he's like, I want to have sex with one of these girls, and like flipping a coin and basically like, I'm fucking you. And she's like, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. This is like, it's
pretty creepy.
I will say this. I will give props to the fact that these are all practical effects.
Yeah.
This is not CGI. They did a really cool job with a lot of it, which I appreciate, especially now day and age. A lot of budgets are big. Obviously for this one, this is a low budget film. But like
it looked good. Kills looked great.
It looked good. And like if you can do that without having to rely on CGI, and then in that case, if you decide to do CGI, then it's bad CGI. It can fucking ruin your whole movie.
It'll look like garbage.
So we're at a point now where Jinx, one of the characters, Jinx old and Bambi. Jinx. Bambi is giving him the old fellatio.
Oral pleasure.
Yeah. Give him a BJ, and Sasquatch kills both of them mid BJ.
Well, he kills the girl. He lives for like a little bit longer because he gets his dick bit off.
Yes,
because the
so he rips off Barbie's while she's giving him a BJ.
Yeah, because he just like punches her on the top of the head, which causes her to bite his dick off, and she dies like immediately. And then he's like, "Oh God," because his dick got bit off.
So they right when that happens, they're like, "Hey, you've seen enough. Let's cut to another equal horrifying scene where." The van driver that was jerking off in the beginning, guess what he's doing again?
Oh, yeah.
Jerking
it. Oh, because he was
turns
jerking
around
off.
And vinegar strokes on Sasquatch.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah, because he was jerking it watching his uncle get a BJ or whatever.
Yes.
And then, he freaking, it was like grandma's boy. Like, he turns around. He's like, oh, God, I can't stop.
Exactly.
All over the Sasquatch.
Oh, Lord
I forgot.
Croft. So the Sasquatch rips off his dick.
Oh, yeah.
And smashes his face, leaving him for dead.
Yep.
Pat, who is our bachelor, makes it to the morning, and his fiance finds him and berates him. How dare you? Sorry, Pat, all your friends are dead.
Yeah, because everybody is dead at this point.
And so she shoots and kills the Sasquatch.
Oh, but there's a twist.
Movie over, right? Not so fast. Or so they think. So the police show up and reveal that, remember, it was the aspiring actor in the Bigfoot suit that was killed.
That guy Drew hired.
That's right. So the Sasquatch still hunts.
And, like, I thought it was funny that, like, what was it, like, 15 deep of, like, ambulances and cops show up at the same time. I was like, what? like, that was just crazy to me. But we kind of glossed over, like, what's-his-face, Jinx or whatever. Because remember, doesn't he get his hand caught in a bear trap?
Yeah,
as
so
he's crawling around with his
old boy,
missing his dick?
Well, old boy who got his dick off, and he runs away, and one of his buddies finds him. And he's like, oh, God. And they both run from Sasquatch because Sasquatch is there.
Yeah.
So Jinx turns around and says, hey, grab my dick.
Yeah.
So his boy goes back and grabs his dick
it was
off
Vinny
the
Blades,
ground.
I think.
Vinny Blades.
It. Yeah.
And then they're running and Jinx falls into the...
I think it was a bear trap.
Into the bear trap. And so he loses a dick and then a hand.
And then a hand. And then like he's talking for like 10 minutes.
Yeah.
It was a very long
scene.
He
ends up bleeding out pretty much from blood loss to the dick and hand area.
Yeah.
So yeah, so she kills the Sasquatch. We think the movie's over. It's not the Sasquatch, it's the actor. The Sasquatch still lives. And then they arrest her for murder.
For murder. That was like, yes, take that, bitch.
So, I mean, overall, I guess we can kind of... What's your rating on this movie?
I've contemplated it over the weeks since we've seen it. It's kind of gone up and down. But I want to give it... I'm going to give it probably a 5, maybe 5.5. Because, like, there was a lot of enjoyable parts to it. There was a lot of parts I wish they didn't have in the movie. Because we kind of complained about it. There were some scenes that just dragged on and on. Like, and the beginning part where we skipped over that. Where it was, the two guys yelling in a room, like, to tell us to watch their movie. Mm-hmm. Like, that was pretty bad. But, I mean, that's not a part of the movie. So I'm not going to, put those two together. But, I mean, like, yeah, there were some really good kills. There were some pretty funny parts. But there was a few scenes that just kind of dragged on, like, where What's-His-Face got his hand cut off and he's talking to his boy. That was, like, forever. He should have been dead. Mm-hmm. So, but that's my... I'm going to give it a 5.5. I'm roll with that.
Fair enough.
How about you?
I think I'm going to have to go, like, a 4.5. And the only reason I say that, like, if you're going to watch this movie, like, know what you're getting into.
Yeah.
Right? Like, this is a indie film. This is not... something that you're going to find on Netflix. I believe it might be on Tubi, though. You know, Tubi is where a lot of this studio's films go there. I'm not sure if this one is or not, but if you're going to go out there and you're going to check this one out, go watch it. Don't let our ratings of like a 4.5, a 5 out of 10, sway you. It's a fun watch. It is a bit long. I think it was probably like 30 minutes too long. They could have cut some dialogue and some key areas that just didn't do a whole lot to enhance the film. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't funny either. If it was funny and I'm like laughing during it, I might let it go. But yeah, I felt like it kind of drug.
Yeah, it just dragged on. There was no need for it.
And I actually kind of go back to your part about the two guys yelling. In the beginning of the movie, you get like this little bit. It's probably, I mean, it might have been like 5-7 minutes.
It was way too long. And the audio is such shit.
Right. It's Vinny Blades and...
Was it Jinx?
It might have been Jinx, the characters. And they're in like ski masks like from the beginning when they did the abduction of their friend. Yeah. And they're basically yelling about censorship. And actually... from what listening to the podcast, a lot of these indie filmmakers are having a really hard time getting anyone to pick up their movies to put them out to distribute them, to release them, because of a lot of censorship shit. So I guess it's more of like a deeper issue, and this is something that we'll probably get into more as we dive down into a lot of these horror fan made stuff, indie stuff, because it seems like it is a lot harder for them if you don't have the big budget and the big film studios behind you.
Yeah,
and overall, between social media and everything else with censorship today, they're having a hard time, especially with like what we just talked about. We just talked about Sasquatch ripping off dicks, naked chicks, like peeing, like a lot of
like
jizzing,
graphic
like,
stuff.
Graphic stuff. I'd imagine there's probably a lot of Karens out there that are like, how dare you release this filth into,
into our community,
into the environment. Exactly. So
there's an atheist in the movie.
So I'll give it a 4.5 out of 10. It's in our collection now. We've got it on Blu-ray. I'm not mad for spending $20
on it. It was definitely worth a watch for sure.
Exactly. So overall, go check this one out. What was your favorite kill in the movie?
I'm trying to think. I liked it when the freaking, what was his name? Brick.
Yeah.
That was a fun kill. Getting
the BJ one?
Yeah. Well, he was the one that got his dick ripped off.
That's right.
And then face smashed in, I think.
He got crushed.
So I'm going to roll with him. He was my boy, and he got killed in a horrific way.
Fair enough. Oh, man. Who am I going to have to... Favorite kill? I thought the stripper getting her tits ripped off was pretty funny.
That was brutal.
And it was pretty well done from a effects standpoint. Yeah, it did a really good job.
If I remember correctly, like she didn't die right away from that, but didn't he stomp her face in?
Yeah, he stepped on her or something. Yeah, so,
yeah,
so
yeah,
like,
yeah.
I mean,
that was a good one.
That was probably my favorite. So I think that's probably where we're gonna be. So we've done all right. So we've given our ratings. We've done our favorite kills. So, like I said, don't let the ratings deter you. Go watch this film.
Yeah, if you want to see it, see it. I mean, it's got some good quality parts to it. It was decent.
Yeah. So anyway, so we wanted to talk to you just a couple minutes about who we are. We appreciate you if you've listened this long.
Yeah, absolutely.
So we want to tell you just a little bit about us. My name is Ryan. I got into horror a long time ago. It was probably my aunt Stephanie who got me into it, watching a bunch of shit I probably shouldn't have been watching at a younger age. But she always had an appreciation. She's a big Bela Lugosi fan, so she had me watching a lot of the old school Lon Chaney, Lugosi, a lot of the black and white films, and then kind of transitioned me into a lot of really obscure stuff. You know, Bruce Campbell, Bubba Hotep, that was one that she had me watch. Like, just, you know, the kind of the obscure stuff. So that really has started my appreciation for horror.
Yeah.
I'll just do a favorite horror film. So my favorite film, and we're going to do this one, and I swear I could talk for 5 hours on it. It is the classic Lost Boys is my favorite one. I love the horror comedy aspect of it. Probably why I did like Cherokee Creek, which we talked about today, because I like the horror comedy combination.
Yep.
If you do it well, it's really good. It's really hard to pull off. A lot of times it just ends up trashy or kind of campy, but this Lost Boys is by far my favorite horror movie.
Yeah. So, and I'm David, and I have been watching horror movies as far as I can remember, probably 4 or 5 years old ish, seeing things like Child's Play. My parents always let me watch pretty much whatever, because my dad was huge into action, horror, R-rated movies. So I got to see everything at a very young age. I just had to, you know, cover my eyes if there were boobs. So that was it.
So that's what's wrong with you. Got it.
Yeah, so that's what's wrong with me is it's been instilled in me in an early age. But horror movies I've always loved. I've always had a fascination, you know, with just watching the killer stalk people. And, you know, for a while I just loved movies that had the more gore and guts, the better. Yeah. But now I just like, I like dabbling in all sorts of different horror. Like, it doesn't have to have a huge high body count for me to love.
What's your favorite genre?
My favorite genre, I mean, I love zombie movies. I love a good zombie movie, like Romero style zombie movies, because they have a lot of gore and like cool scenes like that. So I'm gonna roll with zombies. That's one of my favorites.
Okay. And your favorite movie?
Favorite horror movie.
Horror movie.
I mean, it's definitely the original Halloween. I remember the first time I saw that, I was just obsessed with Michael Myers. I was like, this is so cool. So I have I've got like 3 Halloween tattoos because of it. Like, I was just like, this is amazing.
It is. As far as slashers go, it's in my top 2.
Yeah, it's great.
So yeah, so appreciate you joining us. Just a little bit about us. We're gonna be, you know, talking about all kinds of movies. So tune in if you're a big fan of movie reviews. We're gonna watch everything from zombies to slashers to possession to
thrillers,
infection movies, anything and everything anything horror.
You can think of. Like, definitely, you know, give us a shout out and say, you know, give us some stuff, you know, to look at. We'll definitely check them out. We'd love to hear from everybody.
Yeah, you can drop a comment or like or drop us an email. You can find us on Instagram, TikTok. Facebook at Sinister Scripts Podcast. So yeah, if you have any movies you want us to watch, let us know. We'll definitely add those to the list. We've got a huge backlog, so as we work our way through it. And join us next week. We're going to be reviewing the 1987 film Near Dark. If you haven't seen that one, it is a great
vampire movie.
Yeah, it is a great old 80s vampire movie. So we will get into that one next week.
Yep.
And thanks for joining us.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Talk to y'all later.
Take care.
Sinister Scripts signing off.
To the end.